Hello everyone. Now the next topic in CMOS inverter is that is the current flow and power dissipation. Let us see the circuit operation and then try to understand the variation in current through the inverter. We know when you vary the input voltage from 0 to VDD level, that is from 0 to VDD level, that is input voltage. This is input voltage. In that case, the devices will be operating in the different regions of operation. If you remember the operation and characteristics, that is voltage transfer characteristics of CMOS, you can refer my previous video. Here, when we change the input voltage from 0 to VDD, NMOS operates from initially it works in cutoff region, then in saturation region, then in ohmic region, and in the similar region, in the same region, first CMOS, PMOS will be working in ohmic region, then in saturation, then in cutoff. You can just refer the voltage transfer characteristics where we discuss about the different regions of operation depending upon the range of input voltage. So initially, when input voltage is less than threshold voltage, this is less than threshold voltage because voltage VGS for this is voltage VGS for NMOS, this is voltage VSGP for PMOS. So when input voltage is less than threshold voltage, NMOS, this is NMOS, will be off and PMOS will be on. This will, for the voltage 0 to threshold voltage, this is off, this is on. This operates in cutoff region, this operates in ohmic region of operation. When this is in cutoff, so current through this device will be 0, and since both are connected in series here, so if current in this is 0, so definitely current in PMOS will also be 0. So current for voltage range between threshold and 0 level is almost 0, right? So that is almost 0. Now, when you increase the voltage from threshold up to voltage VDD, when input voltage becomes more than the threshold voltage, this device will turn on. Remember, whenever a MOSFET changes its operation from cutoff, it will enter into saturation, then into ohmic. If you remember the characteristics of MOSFETs, this is cutoff, this is ohmic, and if when the region of operation changes from cutoff, so it will enter into saturation. This is saturation, this is cutoff, and this is ohmic. So the device will never enter into ohmic region from cutoff directly. It will pass through saturation and vice versa. Device will never pass to cutoff from ohmic. It will always pass through the saturation region of operation. So when you increase the voltage, input voltage, beyond the threshold voltage, this device will enter into saturation. This device will enter from cutoff to saturation, but this device will remain in ohmic region of operation. So initially it was ohmic, it was cutoff, so current was 0. Now this remains in ohmic, but this enter into saturation region, and the equations of current for this is for ohmic region of operation and this is for saturation region. So the device which offers less current, device which carries less current will be the overall current. So this permits current here, ohmic region will permit the current here. Current in this NMOS will be trying to be more, but since it is in ohmic region, so it will restrict the current to this value. So current will increase. So for this range, I repeat, for this range, NMOS cutoff, PMOS ohmic. For this region, NMOS saturation, PMOS ohmic region. But when input voltage becomes equal to VDD by 2, both NMOS and PMOS enter into saturation region, if you remember, and both will be carrying this current, and that is the maximum possible current which will pass through the device, right? So it means your CMOS will be carrying the maximum possible current when both PMOS and NMOS are in saturation region, and that is quadratic variation. This is the equation which will give you the current, right? But please see this, VGS is equal to what? VI, right? So, and VI is how much when both are in saturation? VDD by 2. So maximum possible current of CMOS will be equal to W by, this is N, W by L, and you can take into VDD by 2 minus VT square. That will be the maximum possible current, that is nothing but P current, you can say, right? And this is the expression of P current. Once input voltage becomes more than VDD by 2, now this will enter into saturation. From ohmic to saturation, from ohmic, I have shown you, from ohmic to saturation, and your NMOS will enter into ohmic region of operation. So this enters into saturation, this enters into ohmic region of operation from here to here. And when input voltage goes more than VDD minus threshold, your PMOS enters into cutoff, and this remains in ohmic. That is a sort of symmetrical operation. For this you can refer my previous video, that was voltage transfer characteristic. But this is how we get the expression of the current, maximum current through CMOS circuit, right? CMOS inverter, you can say. Now let us talk about the power dissipation. The power dissipation in NMOS is given by, that is frequency, it depends upon frequency, because when you are talking about dynamic behavior on off, F into C capacitance output DD square. That is the expression of power dissipation, although there was no question in the past on this topic, but you should be knowing. And if you talk about maximum power dissipation, there will be F max here, fine. So that is the power dissipation in CMOS inverter circuit. Now remember one thing, there is one figure of merit, that is called figure of merit of CMOS circuit, and that figure of merit of CMOS circuit is nothing but the product of the power dissipation and the propagation delay, right? So that is called delay power product. This is known as delay power product. This indicates if more is the, basically this figure of merit is the basic parameter which is used for comparison of different IC technologies. When this product should remain constant, or it remains constant for a particular IC technology, so if less is the propagation delay, more will be the power dissipation. Or if more is the power dissipation, or we can say if more is the propagation delay, less will be the power dissipation, and vice versa, fine. So lower power propagation delay means higher is the frequency of operation, and higher will be the power dissipation, fine. That is the meaning of it. Higher is the frequency, higher is the power dissipation. Higher is the frequency means more, less will be the propagation delay, fine. So that is how we define this figure of merit. Then let us talk about another topic again in CMOS circuits, that is the advantages of CMOS. Advantages of CMOS inverter. Advantages, what are important advantages? Number one, the most important, this has got the least power dissipation. Why? Because either of the device remains off, right? So this has got least power dissipation. Second, the voltage swing at output is right from 0 to VDD. So it has got swing right from 0 to VDD. Then it has high output driving capability. in both the directions. Why? Because it is taking very less current. So if it is taking less current, so more and more devices can be connected at the output. Fine. Then input impedance is infinite, so it can drive the large number of gates, a large number of gates connected at output. What is the meaning? If current taken by a stage is less, so your particular device can derive more number of gates. Fine. And this has got a small resistance path between that is output and ground. What is the meaning? Meaning is either of the device will be operating in ohmic region, and that resistance offered by the device in ohmic region is small. So that is the meaning of that, right? And most of the times, the most common question on CMOS is, or we can have one question in digital electronics, that is logic family, which of the following device has lowest power dissipation? And that is CMOS. So this is all about your CMOS theoretical part. Rest I will I will show you some questions in gate which appeared in past, that is questions from gate papers which appeared I think that was in 2007, and another question was in 2009 from CMOS. So we'll see that in my next video. Thank you very much for watching the video.